shouldn't have taken that long, but the pilot bearing inside of the back plate of the cam was seized in there, so I couldn't pull it out. So I had to take a metal cutting bit and go around inside and get it thin to where I could take a chisel and crack it and pull it out. And once that was done, I took sandpaper and just cleaned the edges inside or the inside real good to make sure there's no burrs, and then before I put in the new pilot bearing. Sorry, pilot bushing. So anyway, either word works fine, bearing bushing. But so I got that done, got the clutch installed, and I took and removed the throwout bearing and went up to the other shop and pressed the new one on after pressing the old one off. Tried a couple of squirts of grease in it to make sure there was plenty in there. Cleaned out the inside of the barrel housing. Got everything slid back close. Everything else is going pretty easy, but when you split a tractor, this right here is the hardest thing you'll ever have to do, is put it back together. I hope you enjoyed the little time-lapse version and seen mass confusion at its best. Finally, the light bulb came on. I got some half-inch bolts that I had extra laying from a 45 Farmall M parts tractor. So I was able to use those to line up the back of the engine block with the front of the bell housing. Then I took a pry bar, lined the splines up on the clutch disc to the shaft for the transmission. Got it to slide back together. Now I'm using half inch bolts, about 4 inches long, and I work one side, then I go to the other side and work it on that to try and draw it up evenly. So, light at the end of the tunnel, and I'm just glad it's not an oncoming train. Well, that's about it for the clutch installation. Thank you for watching my frustration. I'm sure you enjoyed it a lot better than I did. Stay tuned for more frustration when we get into the lift control block. Just kidding. But check us out again. Have a good day.